Bam, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of my pathetic life as a homeowner. I honestly feel like the gods in Valhalla fucking hate me. I just bought a GM product right behind me, a lovely vet. This video is not about the vet. This video is about a problem that GM has. They kind of try to bury it, but the reality is it's very, very common. So if you bought a GM product of the following, which I'll show you right here, and you experience a shudder, they quote it as a shudder, or some rumbling while you're driving, then watch this video and I'll explain what's happening, and GM will cover it. But this is a transmission fluid issue, and if you follow me on my channel, one of my most popular videos was this lovely thing right here, and it's transmission fluid issues. So yeah, ironically, I buy a new car. It's not new. It's got it had under 6,000 miles on it. It's 2017 Grand Sport. But ironically, this is my second transmission fluid experience, and I feel like all of a sudden I'm becoming some sort of transmission fluid expert, and I don't want to be. So anyways, this is what's going on. Let's go for a little drive, and I'll give you an example of what you're probably experiencing if you did click on this video. And if you didn't click on this video, and you might be looking for a GM product, just understand that this could happen. So let's go. Sorry, I have to be a douchebag and do a cold start. So what you're gonna experience is at basically most speeds, I'm doing 43 miles per hour right now. This could range between 40-ish and highway speeds. What's gonna happen is your RPMs, your gears are gonna go all the way up to whatever, eighth gear, and then your RPMs are gonna go between 1,000 and 2,000 RPM. When they're in this range, this is where you start experiencing a shudder, or like you're hitting rumble sticks. So for example, right now, I'm driving and my foot is on the accelerator, but I'm not going on or off of it, right? It's this kind of steady pace, right? Exactly what you're gonna experience is a little bit of like a rumbling, as if you're hitting some rumble strips or shudder. And that's exactly what's happening with this transmission. So what's going on in your transmission? Now, this whole thing started with issues in the southern states. There was a lot of people complaining in the southern states that they were having these issues with the car shuddering, and they were blaming it on the transmission at first, the torque converter. And at first they were, GM was pushing back, being like, this ain't our problem. Eventually a class action lawsuit started out of Florida, where I'm at right now, beautiful state of Florida. A class action lawsuit did get started, and it pushed the subject to the point where GM had to start doing something about it. They started replacing torque converters, which is insanely expensive, and then they realized that, hey, it's not the torque converter that's the problem, it's the transmission fluid. Now, transmission fluid is extremely sensitive. As I've said in the past with my Nissan, I had a mixing of transmission fluid with coolant, and it was just, the car wouldn't even run, right? So it's a very similar situation with these GMs in the automatic 8-speed automatics, where contamination gets into the transmission and it basically causes it to slip in the lower RPM ranges of roughly 1,000 to 2,000 range. Why is this happening? Basically, in the humid states like Florida, there's condensation that builds up in the transmission. I'm sure there's some breather ports or something in it, and it gets in. Long story short, water gets into the transmission, and it mixes with the transmission fluid, and then all of a sudden the transmission fluid is garbage. And that is why you experience this issue. How do you get out of this issue? Well, like I said, it is a transmission fluid issue, and luckily GM's figured it out. And the fix from GM at the dealership is to flush the transmission three times with a new type of fluid, which I can't remember off the top of my head, but it is in the service bulletin. So yes, long story short, you'll feel a shuddering. Why is it happening? It's because your transmission fluid is contaminated with water, and the fix is to flush the transmission fluid out. And they have machines set up at all dealerships to do this, so you will get out of it that way. Could it be another transmission issue? Of course it could be, but if you're, like I said, if you're experiencing the shuddering between 1 and 2,000, there's a very good chance you are dealing with a transmission fluid issue, and it will get resolved once you swap in new transmission fluid. Pow, back in the garage. All right, just to kind of follow up. So if you are experiencing that, there is a service bulletin, and that bulletin number is 18-NA-355. So if you Google that, you will bring up the service bulletin. And I honestly, all I did was just print this off, and I went to a GM dealership and I said, here, I think I'm experiencing this. And they're like, yeah, we got you, man. You will likely have this covered under warranty because it looks like here, some of the GM products were from 2015. 2015's the earliest models that had this issue. So anyways, it is an automatic transmission issue. GM will cover it. They know how to fix it now. At one point, they were trying to replace torque converters, which is like a monstrosity of a job. It's like ripping apart the transmission. But it looks like the fluid change does help. Am I concerned whether that's enough or was my torque converter damaged? I am not concerned personally after experiencing what I had to go through with my good old trusty Nissan Xterra, the old girl. It'll be fine. So yeah, that's that. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel. And I deal with a lot of bullshit at home. So if you get entertained by dealing with a lot of bullshit, subscribe. Cheers.